All right, y'all. So let's test out the Glamnetic press-on nails. But we're going to do it in two different ways. So here's the package. I got it in the mail about a week after I ordered it. So it shipped pretty quickly. When you get it, you get the nails. These are not my normal length. These are very, very short compared to what I normally wear. But they were pretty decent in terms of the structure of them. So I finally got it apart, which took forever. But the rest of the nails come in a little bag. They give you a nice little display set for all five of your fingers on each hand. You get a really, really small, you know, file. You also get glue and you get a cuticle pusher. So I'm going to take all of that out. I'm not going to use the glue with these because I want to see if these work with my other products. So I went on ahead and started sizing my nails. I tested the structure to see if they were really strong. They are super strong, very thin at the cuticle and thick at the tip, and they have a lot of strength to them. I like that. So I'm just going to size my nails. It gives you a nice apex as well, which I really enjoyed that. So we're going to size these nails out. And then we're going to move on into the application. So on one hand, I'm going to use primer and base gel, and I'm going to use the whole nine, right? On the other hand, I'm going to use just the primer and the dehydrator and some of the gummy jelly. I'm going to use the gummy jelly on both hands. But I'm only going to use the primer on one hand because I wanted to see if the primer made a difference in how well the nail, you know, held up. Actually, it's base gel. I'm sorry. I use base gel on one hand. So we're going to take our dehydrator and primer by E-Nail Couture. And I got some lint-free wipes here that I'm going to use as well to just help keep my fingernail beds completely clean and free of oils. We're just going to wipe all of that off. So we're going to take some alcohol here, and this is 91% isopropyl alcohol. I get it from Amazon. I buy it in bulk, and I also, you can get it from Sam's Club as well. And I'm just going to clean the nail bed just in case it had any oils or anything on the nails. We're going to clean that all off. And then I'm going to go in with the nail dehydrator again just to give myself an extra buffer, and then I'm going to go in with the primer. All right, so we're going to get a cuticle pusher here and gently push back the cuticle. We're just going to push it back so that the nail can sit on there properly. And also, we can get up any dead skin or product that is under that part. And we can get that cleaned up and have a decent application. And it will adhere to the nail. If there's anything on the nail, it will have lifting. And that's a big issue that I don't want to have to deal with. So I buffed, I cleaned off the nails and did all of that. And now we're doing our dehydration. So we're using the nail dehydrator by E-Nail Couture. We're going to put this on all five fingers. And then we're going to go in with primer. So this is where we're going to start with the application. And this might be a little bit different from what you're used to seeing, because usually most people would use glue with this. But I am going to use my gummy jelly by E-Nail Couture. Okay, and you'll see in a second. So now what I'm going to do is prime the back of the nail that we got from Glamnetic. So we're going to take the nail, and it's dehydrated just in case there was anything on it. And then I'm going to take some of the primer from E-Nail Couture and place that in the back. And then we're going to let it dry completely. And it'll basically like chemically etch the back of that nail to help it adhere longer to my nail. Okay. So on this hand, we put no base gel. This was just primer and the gummy jelly. And that was it. So we're going to go ahead. I put two coats of primer on there just in case, you know, wanted to make sure I had enough primer all over the nail. So I coated it twice and let it dry twice. And now we're going to move into the application. Okay. So we're going to take our gummy jelly out. We're going to unscrew it, get that out. And we're just going to put a small amount in the bottom of the nail bed. Okay. So we're going to finally get our light adjusted and everything. This lamp I got from Amazon. It was a Melody Susie lamp. But what you're going to do is take the nail and we're going to dip it into the pot itself. Now, I know it's going to be difficult for y'all to see because I have my hands in the way and I apologize for that. But all you're going to do is take the product and scrape at the edge of the pot and pull up a small amount. Then we're going to go ahead and place that on the nail here. Just place it on the nail and make sure that the product goes up and fills up the entire nail cavity, which you can see it is filling up the whole cavity. Now, I wanted to make sure that there was no spillage because this nail already has a design on it. I didn't want to damage it and be filing on top. So what I did was I took a cuticle stick and just cleaned up the edges as much as I could without lifting the nail too much. And then I went under that lamp and I cured it. Now, the interesting thing about this is that the UV light was able to penetrate through this nail tip. That's not the case with all nail tips, so I wouldn't recommend this for everything. But the Glamnetic was able to penetrate through with the UV light, and I really appreciate that because I really wanted these to last a little bit. They were pretty cute in terms of length. They were very small, easy to work with, and if you like your nail tips to be short, you don't like really long ones, then these Glamnetic ones would be really cool. And for specific purposes of like durability, strength, and of course for, you know, just for the overall look and length of time you can wear it, these are really good press-ons. I'm very impressed. Glamnetic, they did that. So let's go to the other application. So in this application, we're going to use a base gel. And the base gel is just to help with adhesion. All right. So we're going to go ahead and bring out the base gel. This is Enel Couture's base gel. And we're just going to, I'm very, very happy with my hands, which is why I'm doing all this dainty shit right now. Child. Anyway, I'm so extra, child. But we're going to do the same application, dehydrate the nail. Then we're going to add primer and then we're going to add base gel. And that is going to be the overall consensus. Everything else is going to be the same. So I'm just going to show you guys that again and then we'll get to the end and I'll explain what happened with the nails after some time. All right, so now I can show you a little bit clearer as to how we get the product in the nail, or at least how I do it. I just take the nail and put it right on the edge of the pot where the product is already sort of at the edge. And then I just add just enough in there. You don't need a lot. You need enough to cover that whole nail. So you're going to take it and then place it onto the nail. And then as you press, the product will disperse throughout the nail bed. And you're going to let that cure under the lamp for a good 30 seconds at best. You want to give it enough time to cure so that it doesn't pop off. And then once you put your hands in the lamp, you can go ahead and fully cure the product. Okay, so we're going to clean up that excess product that cured or, you know, had a little spillage out on the outside. We're just going to take some cuticle nippers. These are some dull ones, so they won't nip the skin. We're going to take that and just snip off that excess gel. Try not to break that seal too much because it will lift if you break the seal. But we're just going to snip off the excess gel on the nail bed. And I'm not cutting my cuticles or anything. I'm literally lifting up that product that spilled out. And we're just cutting that off, as you can see. Okay? So we're going to get rid of that. Get the nails all cleaned up. You know, we're going to do every nail like that because all of them have spillage because I can never go without doing it, without putting product somewhere. It's going to squeeze out somewhere. Usually, if I had a tip and this was clear and I was decorating it, I would have already filed it off or, like, filed it down. But when it's like a big bubble of product, I go ahead and just cut the nail down. I mean, cut down that product and get it off. So, but again, like you can see how these Glamnetic nails have really nice apexes in them, and they're very good tips if you like them this short. So I did end up fouling just a little bit. I can't help it. I had to, so I could make that cuticle look flush and it looked more natural. I like these. These are really cute. These would be some good wedding nails. If you were getting married, these would be some good wedding nails for you to use. But I went on ahead and I added some top coat, and this is from E-Nail Couture. This is one of their, I believe this is one of their Dom top coats, and it has sparkles in it. It's like iridescent almost. I wanted that look to it. It gave it this really pretty shine. So I went on ahead and top coated the nail with that. And that helped protect the design of this nail tip and everything. So I was happy with these nails until about a week in. And I wish I would have kept the video footage of this, but I didn't. My nails on my left hand, which is the hand that did not have the it didn't have the base gel, they began to pop off within a week of me wearing them. And the nails on my right hand with the base gel and everything, they stayed on for a very long time. I ended up having to remove them, and they were very difficult to remove. I will say this. If you're going to use the Glamnetics the way I use them with the E-Nail Couture products and everything like that, then I highly recommend that you use a base gel if you want to keep them for a long period of time. If you are just using them for 5 minutes or a few seconds, then you don't need the base gel and simply just, you know, add some glue and they'll last for a couple weeks, maybe. But as you can see, I needed to put a top coat on here because I had pretty much taken off the top coat that they had on there. And so me adding that top coat really revived the nail. And of course, it's protecting the current design that it has. But I had to file that bottom so it looked more flush to my nail. I had to. I couldn't just leave it like that. And this top coat was really pretty. It added another level of shine and sparkle to it that I didn't know I really needed, but it looked gorgeous when I did it, so I was happy. So I'm going to clean up that edge with that excess, and then we're going to do this last nail here and go ahead and pop these in the machine so they can cure, and then you guys will see the final results. So I'm going to go ahead and spray my hands down with some Swipe. This is from Young Nails. And I really liked these Glamnetic nails. They were simple. They were small. They looked decent. My hands looked nice, which I love. They didn't get in the way. And I really liked them. They weren't super expensive. I got them on sale, but Glamnetic always has some type of sale on their nail tips. You can order them in bulk or you can order them individually. I got these, and the only thing I will say that I had an issue with was the sizing. There's not enough sizes in there for you to wear these tips multiple times, which that can be problematic, especially if you really like the design. You would have to go back and repurchase them. But overall, these were decent nails. They are sturdy. They do not break. Like, they will not break at all. So you can pop a can like they show you in all the pictures. I would recommend, if you want them to be longer than a few weeks, that you use a base gel and then use maybe a a gummy jelly like I use from E-Nail Couture, or maybe use a poly gel, clear poly gel, because I know for a fact that that will cure all the way through. And then you can just soak these off. In the end, I say it's well worth the buy. I say go check them out for yourself.